okay, this is going to happen to students. You're going to look at my work and say, oh, there must be an error over here because they see this line over here, then they see this one over here, and they say, that couldn't be true because if you had a 21 to both sides, you wouldn't get minus 18. So what I want to do is, you know, I would say take a pause sometimes and think about it before you look at the key, all right? But I am looking at the key, by the way. What I would do, all right, notice I got a negative exponent and a positive exponent. So what I want to do is I want to multiply both sides by x to the 2 fifths. And what would I get over there? Well, you get 4x to the 4 fifths minus 18. Well, minus 2 fifths plus 2 fifths is 0. Equals minus 21 x to the 2 fifths. Next step, I'm trying to get a 0 in the problem. X to the 4 fifths plus 21 x to the 2 fifths minus 18 equals 0. I want to show you where that is right over here, all right? So we were able to get what they have in the key, all right? Again, you might say, why'd you do that? I did that, I don't want to done something different another day, but I did that, and that's fine. You could do something different. I'm not saying it's the only path to the answer. Now here comes my trouble. I'm looking at it, and I want to factor it. So I'm going to say, I don't know. I'm seeing this, you know, the 4, the 18, and the 21, and I'll try to write something down over here. So I'm going to say 4x to the 2 fifths. Whatever I do say, I'm going to check it, by the way. X to the 2 fifths. That equals 0. And let's see, 6 and 3. Plus, minus, let me just check it. You get 4x to the 4 fifths. That worked beautifully. 24 minus 3 is 21x to the 2 fifths. Yeah, looks good. What do you get over here? And again, it's kind of nightmarish, but you could write it down. And what do you get over here? Let's see, 4x to the 2 fifths equals 3. And then you get x to the 2 fifths equals minus 6. All right. X to the 2 fifths equals 3 quarters. Whoa. X squared is equal 3 to the 5th, 4 to the 5th. I don't want to do that, by the way. But here's the deal. X is equal to plus or minus the square root 3 to the 5th over 4 to the 5th. I'm going to write this a little bit differently. Plus or minus. I want to do the top first. And let's see, 3 to the 4, so it'll be 3 squared, which is a 9. And it'll be left with a root 3. On bottom, it's actually 4 to the 10th. I'm sorry, 2 to the 10th. And the square root of 2 to the 10th is 2 to the 5. What's 2 to the 5? It's 32. Let me just check that. 2 times 2 is 4, 8, 16, 32. Works good. Do we get that? We do. It's right over here. Let me do the other one. It's more difficult. At least I believe it is. What do you get? X squared is actually minus 6 to the 5th power, which is the same thing as x squared minus 6 to the 5th power. X equals plus or minus I root 6 to the 5th power. I got to do this now. What do you get? X equals plus or minus I. You know what? I'm kind of jamming that in there. I'm just going to write it over, and I'll put it over here. Let me go get my little... Whoops. I'm going to write this as X equals plus or minus I. And then I'm going to say, you know, square root of 6, 4... square root of 6. What do you get over here? X equals plus or minus. Well, that would be 6 squared, which is 36 root 6. Let me clean it up. Plus or minus 36i root 6. All right, let's see if we got that answer. And I'm staring at that answer over there. By the way, conventions, a lot of people like the convention where the I is at the very end of it. I like to put it before the root, by the way. But again, You might look at an answer key somewhere and see 36, root 6, and then see an I right there. It's the same thing, all right? Thank you.